Hi, welcome back. Thank you for joining me for this next slide on our Dust Bowl DBQ. We're going to talk about the background essay now. It's very important that you understand what happened to cause the Dust Bowl and everything that happened during that time period. So on Thursday, April 18 of 1835, a huge black cloud appeared in the western sky over Stratford, Texas. It was the arrival of another dust storm. In the 1930s, 300 dust storms struck the small towns and farms of the southern Great Plains. Newspaper reporters at the time called this event the Dust Bowl. For thousands of years, the southern Great Plains were covered by short grass prairie. It was home to great herds of 20 to 30 million buffalo. In more recent times, people arrived. First came the Apache and the Comanche and the Kiowa. Shortly after the Civil War, cowboys arrived with millions of cattle. Then in the 1880s came the farmers. With few trees for lumber, many of these early farmers lived in soddies, or houses made of earth and grass. Soddies were replaced, eventually, with frame houses. A severe drought in the 1890s caused some farm families to move away, so the federal government offered a deal. New settlers were given 320 acres if they could survive on the land for 3 years. Thousands of families took them up on this offer. A new favorite crop was wheat, and it was making some farmers rich. Wheat sold for 93 cents a bushel in 1914, sold for $2.50 in 1919. More families moved to the southern plains. Small towns popped up like spring flowers. Boise City, out near the end of the Oklahoma Panhandle, had a new theater, a newspaper, a furniture store, a bank, and several cafes. But then came the trouble. The Great Depression of the 1930s was the first blow. Unemployment went back east and made it harder to sell the wheat. Sadly, the Depression did not come alone. What made life extra hard on the plains was the dust storm. In the mid-1930s, these wind-driven storms darkened the midday sky. They carried tons of precious soil as far east as Chicago, even Washington, D.C. During this time, more than 3 million plains settlers left their farms, some for town, some for neighboring states, some as far away as California. Many more, however, stayed put. They covered their windows with wet sheets. They ate jackrabbit stew beneath an eating cloth that kept the dust out of their food. Nevertheless, children died from breathing in the dust, and they called it dust pneumonia. Life on the plains during the 1930s was so tough that writer Timothy Egan titled his book on the Dust Bowl, The Worst Hard Time. But what exactly happened to cause this worst hard time? Read the documents that follow and do your best to answer the question, what caused the Dust Bowl?